हेलो हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग।
यस मैम, गुड मॉर्निंग।
एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस मैम।
ओके, व्हाट वी हैव लर्न डे बिफोर यस्टरडे फ्रॉम दिस फुटनोट एंड एफोरिज्म, फोर पॉइंट्स वी हैव सीन रिगार्डिंग अवर सोरा, कि व्हाई इट इज द मदर ऑफ ऑल द माइजम्स। What are they? Anyone?
Hello?
Yes, give the answer. Anjali? Anjali, are you giving the answer?
Hello, ma'am.
Hello.
Your voice is breaking. Your voice is breaking.
Anybody else? Niranjan? Aisha, Priyanka, what we have seen in the aphorism number 81? Only two or three students have posted me that monster headed Sora. Komal, Anjali, Vaishnavi. What about other students? Which points are given in this aphorism? 81 aphorism?
Ma'am, हेलो मैम,
सांग
मैम, इट इज एंशियंट मायाजम, एंशियंट मायाजम एंड शोइंग कंजेनिटल कोऑपरेटिव इनक्रेडिबल कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, देन शोइंग ग्रेट वैरायटी, देन सोरा इज इंजुरियस एजेंट, एजेंसी ऑफ डिसीजेस, इट इज नॉट डिपेंड ऑन बिफोर वर्क, इट इज न्यू ऑल द टाइम्स, देन इट एक्टिंग means within and without, inside and outside also.
Yes.
And right. Transmitted from generation to generation. And then chronic miasm is the base.
Right. Very good. And then in the footnote, they have Dr. Haniman has given how the allopathic physicians are giving the various name to the palliation of the sora, though they are the manifestation of the sora only, but they are giving the different names, and because of that, this leads to the suppression. Though they have given the various examples by which they have shown ki these are all the palliation of the sora, they are not a new disease. Now the last paragraph of this footnote, if however it is deemed necessary sometimes to make the use of the name of the disease in order when talking about the patient to ordinary persons to render ourselves intelligent, in few words, we ought only to employ them as a collective names and tell them. For example, the patient has a kind of St. Vitreous dance, a kind of dropsy, a kind of typhus. So in the previous aphorism, Dr. Hanneman has given ki what the qualities should possess to the true physician. If you remember, we have learned this paragraph ki the true physician should not practice on the basis of these names of the disease. These names are useless and they are misused by certain physician. We should not judge the medicine on the basis of these names of disease, and the cure will not be there. So what we required? We require the similarity of the symptom with that of the medicine. Second thing he said that we should not prescribe on the basis of this single one from all the other symptoms. But what we have to do, we have to make the totality of the signs and symptoms of that particular individual patient. And we should not depend on the hypothetical guess. We should carefully investigate the patient. So these three points he has explained in the previous paragraph. And with the reference to that, he said ki, if the patient wants the name of the disease, because whenever there are the signs and symptoms, we are giving the medicine. The patient is having the loose motion, stomach ache, nausea and vomiting. Directly we will give on the and a clean tongue. Then we will give the Ipecac. If that person is having the greenish and the yellowish discharges, the patient is thirsty, the patient is hot, then we will not run behind the diagnosis. Directly we will give the Pulsatilla. If the patient is having the morning diarrhea with the irritability, with the meat eating habit, directly we will give the Nuxvomica, or bahar ka kuch khaya hai to we will give the Nuxvomica. So on the basis of totality of the symptom, we are giving the medicines. We are not running behind that name of the disease. But still, if that patient wants the name of disease, so you can explain to the patient by intelligent words. So unko kaun se shabd chahiye hamare se, yani from the physician, ki that person may have the typhoid, that person may have the fever of any type. Aise unko naam chahiye. The St. Vitreous dance, that is again the disease. Typhus, dropsy, ye sab agar unko humne naam bol diye patient ko, the patient will happy ki mujhe ye disease hua hai. Usko ek man mein lagta hai, bapre mujhe ye disease hua hai. So he patient ko aisa lagta hai ki agar mujhe naam nahi bataya gaya disease ka, that means that physician is not knowing anything. वो फिजिशियन डायग्नोसिस नहीं कर पा रहा है. सो हाउ यू कैन प्रिस्क्राइब द मेडिसिन टू मी, बिकॉज वॉट दे आर हैविंग द हैबिट फ्रॉम द ओल्ड स्कूल कि ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ डायग्नोसिस द मेडिसिन हैज टू बी प्रिस्क्राइब. अगर उसको एलर्जी है तो सिट्रिजिन देनी है. अगर उसको वीकनेस है सो उसको टॉनिक देना है. अगर उसको एनेमिया है तो हमको आयरन टॉनिक एंड आयरन टैबलेट्स देना है. सो द पेशेंट इज ऑल्सो हैविंग द हैबिट कि मुझे ये नाम पता चल गया है, नाउ आई कैन टेक दिस मेडिसिन. लेकिन हमारा उल्टा है. वी आर नॉट रनिंग बिहाइंड द डायग्नोसिस और नेम ऑफ दैट डिजीज. वॉट वी वॉन्ट द लॉट्स ऑफ साइंस एंड सिम्टम्स. अब उसमें से हम लोग पिक्यूलियर हमको निकाल लें. हमको बहुत ज़्यादा क्यों चाहिए? बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट द पिक्यूलियर, और पिक्यूलियर हमको बहुत ज़्यादा में से दो चार ही मिलते हैं. इफ़ यू आर टेकिंग द 10 सिम्टम्स फ्रॉम द पेशेंट, उसमें से नियर अबाउट 7 सिम्टम्स विल बी द कॉमन सिम्टम विच आर अप्लीकेबल टू द डिसीज एंड दैट विल बी हेल्पफुल फॉर द डायग्नोसिस of the disease. But for the prescription, we only got the 3 symptoms, and on the basis of that totality we have to give the medicine. So we are not running behind the name ka kya karna hai. If the symptoms are there, give the medicine, because our proving is also based on the on that signs and symptoms. Ki clean tongue hai to Ipecac dena hai, ड्राई टंग है तो पल्सेटिला देना है, या फिर व्हाइटिश कोटिंग टंग है तो दूसरी कोई मेडिसिन देनी है, येलोइश टंग है तो और दूसरी कोई मेडिसिन निकलेगी, फिटेड ओडर है, डिस्चार्जेस है, सो वी विल गिव द एंटीसाइकोटिक मेडिसिन, ब्लाइंड डिस्चार्जेस है, रनिंग नोज है, वी विल गिव द एलियम सीपा. सो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दीज कैरेक्टरिस्टिक वी आर गिविंग द मेडिसिन. हम लोग अस्थमा के लिए, निमोनिया के लिए, वी आर नॉट गिविंग द मेडिसिन लाइक दिस, बिकॉज फॉर द निमोनिया वी आर हैविंग द ब्लटा ओरिएंटालिस, फॉर अस्थमा ऑल्सो वी आर हैविंग ब्लटा ओरिएंटालिस, फॉर द निमोनिया वी कैन गिव pulsed hila, we can give the arsenic. So depending upon the presentation of the patient, we are giving the medicine. But if still your patient wants the name of that disease, जो उन्होंने नाम दिया है, ऐसा कुछ तो भी नाम उसको चाहिए. सो उसको कॉन्फिडेंस आता है कि यस, अगर इसको नाम पता है फिजिशियन को तो ही कैन प्रिस्क्राइब वेल. सो यू कैन गिव द नेम बाय योर इंटेलिजेंट वर्ड्स. क्लियर? व्हाट पॉइंट्स आर गिवन इन द एफोरिज्म नंबर 81? इन द एफोरिज्म ही हैज एक्सप्लेन हाउ द सोरा इज important or how the sora is the mother of all the mysm. Through the many years it is acting on the human beings. It is causes the innumerable morbid development. Though the circumstances are different, but the sora is the background. That's because of the different circumstances he is showing the great varieties of chronic diseases. It may be the congenital corporeal diseases or it may be the injurious things like convulsions or hemorrhoids that he has given the example afterward. So this sora is the cause of all the diseases. If it is get palliated, the different diseases are arising. In the footnote, he has given again the different examples of sora, but how the old school are treating them, they treat it as a new disease. They are not considering any palliation or any suppression. And then in the next paragraph or in the last two paragraph, Dr. Hanuman has explained how the true physician should treat that person without taking any single symptom, without...
Ma'am, aawaz bahut kat rahi hai aapki.
Sab koi break ho rahi hai?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Aata hai toh? Yes, ma'am. Now it is breaking.
No, ma'am.
Huh?
No, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Ab aa rahi hai.
Okay. So these are the points explaining the aphorism. Huh? What happened? Ye toh ek aawaz aa rahi hai kya abhi ki nahi? My voice is breaking or now it's clear? Hello?
Ma'am, aawaz hi itni hai tumcha.
Hello. Ma'am, nahi.
Aata hai toh? Ye toh hai ka? Hello?
हाँ ये तो मैम
am I audible or not?
Yes ma'am.
Yes ma'am.
मधेस ते इंटरनेट कनेक्शन अनस्टेबल झालं होतं. ओके, प्लीज एनीबडी रीड दिस एफोरिज्म 82.
कैन आई?
ओके
आयशा.
Read Aisha.
As also by the discovery of the specific homeopathic remedies for the sora, medicine has advanced some steps nearer. Ma'am, aphorism 82.
Okay, read from the beginning.
Also by the discovery of that great, as also by the discovery of the to a knowledge of the nature of the majority of diseases it has to cure, yet for setting the indication in each case of chronic psoriatic disease he is called on to cure, the duty of a careful apprehension of its ascertainable symptoms and characteristics is as indispensable for the homeopathic physician as it was before that discovery. As no real cure of this or of other diseases can take place without a strict particular treatment, individualization of each case of disease. Only that in this investigation, some difference is to be made when the affection is an acute and rapidly developed disease. And when it is a chronic one, seeing that in acute disease, the chief symptoms strike us and become evident to the senses more quickly. and hence much less time is requisite for tracing the picture of the disease, and much fewer questions are required to be asked, as almost everything is self-evident, than in a chronic disease which has been gradually progressing for several years, in which the symptoms are much more difficult to be ascertained.
Okay, thank you, Aisha. So they have given here the introduction of the case taking, okay, how it is important, because from the aphorism number 83 to 104, all the points are regarding, or all the aphorisms are related to the case taking. So although by the discovery of great source of chronic diseases, now what are the sources of chronic diseases? Myzoms. So उन्होंने कहा है कि अभी यानी aphorism number ये 81 लिखने तक discovery of chronic diseases हो गए थे. उसके बाद क्या हुआ था? As also by the discovery of specific homeopathic remedy for sora. So which medicine we are giving for sora? Which medicine we are giving?
Thuja.
Sora ke liye thuja denge. Thuja is what?
Thuja is for psychosis.
Then for sora? Anti? Which medicine?
Antisoric.
So up to this point, जब उन्होंने 82 aphorism लिखा, and up to that point, the discovery of myzoms हो गए थे. According to that, उन्होंने classify कर लिए थे कि these are the antipsychotic medicine, these are the antisoric medicine. Third क्या हुआ था? The medicine had advanced some step nearer to the knowledge of nature of the majority of the disease it has to cure. बहुत सारे मेडिसिन्स क्योर करने लगे थे डिसीजेस, एंड नाउ जो वो मेडिसिन अभी रेमेडी में कन्वर्ट हो गए थे. येट फॉर सेटिंग द इंडिकेशन इन ईच ऑफ क्रॉनिक डिसीज ही कॉल्ड इज टू क्योर. जहाँ पे क्रॉनिक डिसीज अच्छे से क्योर हो गया था सोरा, देन ही कॉल्ड इट एज अ क्योर. ये सब चीजें 81 एफोरिज्म या 82 एफोरिज्म उन्होंने जब लिखा तब हो गए थे. सो क्या क्या हुआ था? डिस्कवरी ऑफ माइजम हुआ था, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ मेडिसिन हुए थे, मेडिसिन आर नाउ गिविंग द रिजल्ट फॉर द मेजोरिटी ऑफ द डिसीज, एंड देन ही नेम इट एज अ एंटी माइजमेटिक मेडिसिन. सो फॉर दैट, सो टू क्योर ऑल द पेशेंट्स इन द फ्यूचर, वॉट वी हैव टू डू, इट इज़ अवर ड्यूटी. ये सब क्यों चीज़ें हुई है, या फिर हमको और आगे जाके क्या करना है, it is our duty of careful apprehension of its ascertainable symptoms and characteristic, as it is indispensable for the homeopathic physician, as it was before that discovery. Lekin ye discovery hone ke pehle unko kya karna pada tha, ki careful observation unhone kiya for the characteristic symptoms, because without that it is not possible to give the medicine, to give the proper cure to that disease, as no real cure of this or other disease can takes place without strict particular treatment of each case of disease. अगर ये careful investigation नहीं हुआ होता, या फिर the classification of medicine अगर proper नहीं हुई होती, so it is very difficult to do the individualization of the disease as well as the individualization of medicine. Only that is the investigation. Some difference is to be made when the affection is acute and rapidly developed disease. So what thing they is required for all these discoveries? That is the proper investigation, that is the careful observation. So he said that ki there is a slight difference for that investigation jo maine kiye hai for the acute and for the rapidly developing diseases, and when it is a chronic one. So acute में थोड़े से investigation यानी थोड़े से case taking हम different लेंगे from that of the chronic one, because for the chronic the sora myzom or the psychosis myzom is behind, and for that we have to take the detailed history. But on the other hand, for the acute diseases or rapidly developing diseases, there is no time to take the detailed history. We have to prescribe the medicine on the basis of the jo bhi symptom wo patient de raha hai, within that few minutes we have to give the medicine, because the patient life is more important. So there is a slight difference in between acute and the chronic investigation. Yahan pe investigation means the case taking, not the pathological investigation. Seeing that in acute disease, the chief symptom strikes us and became evident to senses more quickly, and hence less time is required or requisite for tracing the picture of the disease. So, जैसे मैंने अभी बताया कि in the acute one, the chief symptoms are is only one. The other symptoms are very less, and they are evident to our senses very quickly. On the basis of that, we can select our medicine very easily. So, this require the less time. Because in the acute cases, what happen ki एक दिन पहले दो दिन पहले हुआ है तो symptoms इतने develop नहीं होते हैं. So दो या तीन symptoms मिलेंगे, वो भी आपको अगर peculiar मिल गए, so और कम time लगेगा आपको to select the medicine or to trace the picture of the disease. And few questions भी आपको वहाँ पे पूछने पड़ेंगे patient को. लेकिन as almost everything is self-evident होते हैं acute में, लेकिन क्रॉनिक डिसीज में क्या होता है, द क्रॉनिक डिसीज इज डेवलपिंग ग्रेजुअली फ्रॉम मेनी ईयर्स. वहाँ पे पैलेशन होता है, वहाँ पे सप्रेशन के हमको क्वेश्चन पूछने पड़ते हैं. सो इन दैट मेनी सिम्टम्स वी विल गेट, एंड दिस इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू असर्टन कि ओरिजिनल सिम्टम है या आर्टिफिशियल डिसीज के सिम्टम है, विच मेडिसिन वी हैव टू क्यू. सो क्रॉनिक केसेस या क्रॉनिक डिसीजेस के लिए वी हैव टू टेक द प्रॉपर केस टेकिंग, और यहाँ पे इन्वेस्टिगेशन करने के लिए टाइम लगता है. बट ये सब जब उनको पता चला दैट इज एक्यूट जल्दी हो जाएगा, क्रॉनिक थोड़ा टाइम लगेगा, ये दोनों चीज़ें उनको कैसे समझ में आई, बाय द प्रॉपर इन्वेस्टिगेशन, बाय द केयरफुल ऑब्जर्वेशन. सो द विद द हेल्प ऑफ द मायज़म, विद द हेल्प ऑफ एंटी मायज़मेटिक मेडिसिन एंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ देयर क्योर, ये सब करने के बाद he concluded that if the disease is acute, so less time is required. If the disease is chronic, that means the miasm is sora, we have to give the antisoric medicine, and this require the much more amount of time and careful investigations as compared to the acute diseases, because they are require the less time to ask the question, the presentations are very less, few questions we have to ask, and we can trace the picture of the disease very easily, kyunki ek do din mein hi zyada progress nahi hota hai wo disease ka. So this is, in this way the acute case thodi different rahegi as compared to the chronic one. Hence the following directions of investigating the symptom are only partially applicable for acute diseases. Abhi niche hum log jo 83 se 105 tak that aphorism we will start. So wahan pe unhone kaha hai ki the rules are same, but there are the slight changes for acute and for the chronic one. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Pranjali, Pooja, Pooja Sherke, Pooja Uzharkar, Pooja Balika. सहर, अलीशा, स्नेहल, श्वेता पाटिल, उर्वी, जीवन, सुशांत, एनी प्रॉब्लम अप टू द एफरिज्म नंबर 82?
नो मैम.
No, ma'am.
किसी को कुछ पूछना है?
No, ma'am.
पक्का?
ma'am. हेलो मैम,
Shall we start aphorism 83?
Ma'am.
हाँ.
मॅम त्यांनी त्याच्यामध्ये सांगितलं की अक्यूट डिझीजला आपल्याला काही सिम्पटम्स वरच मेडिसिन प्रिस्क्राइब करायची
बरोबर
सांगेल. पण मग सपोज ती जर का मायझम वर असेल म्हणजे जसं त्यांचं डिस्चार्जेस वगैरे मग ते कसं आपण काही सिम्पटम्स वर बघणार?
नाही नाही काही सिम्पटम वर मेडिसिन द्यायची असं नाही म्हटलंय त्यांनी. प्रेझेंटेशन म्हणजे साइन्स अँड सिम्पटम्स लेस असतात. हे बघ चीफ सिम्पटम्स स्ट्राइकर्स अँड बिकेम एव्हिडेंट टू अवर सेन्सेस मोर क्विकली हेन्स लेस टाइम इज रिक्वायर्ड. जे सिम्पटम्स पेशंट येतात ना ते कमी असतात.
ओके मॅम.
आता सपोज तू म्हणते की डिस्चार्जेस ऑफेन्सिव्ह आहे किंवा फिटेड आहे आणि अजून असे काही सिम्पटम्स मिळाले की विच आर रिलेटेड टू द मायझम, तर मग आता आपण पहिल्यांदा कसं करतो अक्यूट मध्ये की अक्यूट प्रूड मेडिसिन्स देतो. आता ह्या ज्या अक्यूट प्रूड मेडिसिन्स आहे ह्या बहुतेक सगळे मायझम्स कव्हर करतात. जसं आर्सेनिक आहे सगळे मायझम कव्हर करते, बेलाडोना, त्याच्यानंतर रस्टॉक्स, आर्निका, सो मोर ऑर लेस हे सगळे मायझम्स क्लिअर करतात म्हणजे त्याच्यामध्ये असतातच. सो स्टार्टिंग एकदम अँटी मायझमॅटिक मेडिसिननी करण्याची गरज नसते आपल्याला. अक्यूट प्रूड मेडिसिननी जर पेशंटला बरं वाटत असेल तर देर इज नो प्रॉब्लेम. पण अक्यूट प्रूड मेडिसिन दिल्यानंतर परत 8 दिवसांनी 15 दिवसांनी रिपीट आले सिम्पटम्स परत आपण अक्यूट प्रूड मेडिसिन दिले आणि इफ इट इज रिकरंट झालं हे परत 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 पेशंट येतोय 8-15 दिवसांनी सो ॲट दॅट टाइम तुम्हाला अँटीमायझमॅटिक मेडिसिन द्यावी लागेल. पण असं हे हा काही रूल नाही आहे की यू शूड स्टार्ट विथ ऑल द अक्यूट प्रूड मेडिसिन. इट इज सजेशन बाय हिम, इट इज हिज ऑब्झर्वेशन. म्हणून त्यांनी इथे सांगितलं आहे ना आपल्याला की हे जे सगळं झालेलं आहे हे केअरफुल ऑब्झर्वेशन आणि इन्व्हेस्टिगेशन वरून झालेलं आहे. सो यू कॅन स्टार्ट विथ नोझोड ऑल्सो, यू कॅन स्टार्ट विथ द ॲनिमल किंगडम ऑल्सो, यू कॅन स्टार्ट विथ द हायर पोटन्सी, यू कॅन स्टार्ट विथ द अँटीमायझमॅटिक मेडिसिन. हे प्रत्येकाचा एक्सपिरियन्स आणि प्रत्येकाच्या ऑब्झर्वेशनवर असतं. ही सेफ वे किंवा त्यांनी जे काही वे घेतला होता हा त्यांनी तिथे सांगितलेला आहे. युअर वे ऑफ प्रिस्क्रिप्शन कॅन बी डिफरंट, पण काही तिथे चुकीचं होणार नाही आहे. कारण तुमचं बेसिक जे आहे की दॅट यू हॅव टू सिलेक्ट द मेडिसिन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ सिमिलर सिम्पटम, दिस बेसिक इफ इट इज अ प्रॉपर, इफ यू आर फॉलोइंग दिस बेसिक देन नो बडी विल स्टॉप यू, डेफिनेटली यू विल गेट द क्युअर. क्लिअर क्लिअर कोमल?
येस मॅम.
ओके एनीवन, अजून कोणाला काही विचारायचं आहे? बिकॉज फ्रॉम एफोरिझम 83 वी विल स्टार्ट केस टेकिंग. तर हे पहिले पॉईंट्स क्लिअर हवे की अक्यूट आणि क्रॉनिक मध्ये थोडासा डिफरन्स असतो का, डिफरन्स असतो आणि का त्यांनी असं म्हटलंय. कारण तोपर्यंत बिकॉज अप टू दॅट टाइम मायझम्स वॉज डिस्कवर्ड अँड देन ही फाउंड आउट दॅट की अक्यूट रिक्वायर द लेस अमाऊंट ऑफ, असं नाही आहे, इट इज नॉट कंपल्सरी की अक्यूट रिक्वायर द लेस अमाऊंट. इफ द सिम्पटम्स ऑफ द पेशंट आर 10 देन डेफिनेटली यू विल गेट द मोर टाइम. इफ द पेशंट इज हायपोकॉन्ड्रिक, if the patient is very shy, so depending upon their nature the case taking will increase. Shy patient ahe, acute case ahe, bolatas nahi hai patient, so in that case you will require the more amount of time. This is a common thing they have given ki generally baba acute madhe the presentations are less, that's why less amount of time, and that's why the slight difference is there. Because here we are not taking the differences are what we are not taking generally the past history. Then we are not taking here the family history. If the patient is chronic asel ta generally apna family history deto. Acute madhe we are asking 4-5 questions, usme se ek peculiar milta hai and we are giving the medicine. Chilly hai, hot hai, thirst hai, thirstless hai, weakness hai, nahi hai, pain hai, which type of pain, modalities we are taking. On the basis of that it is very easy to prescribe the medicine. Okay. No one wants to ask. Shall I move further?
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Read someone this aphorism 83.
Ma'am, me vachu?
Vacha.
Aphorism 83. This individualizing examination of the case of the disease for which I shall only give in this place general directions of which the practitioner will bear in the mind only what is applicable for each individual case. Demands of the physician nothing but freedom for pressured eyes and sound senses. Attention in observing and fidelity in the tracing of the picture of the disease.
Okay, so this is about the case taking. This individualize हमने कैसे करना सीखा है? By the miasm, by the anti-miasmatic medicine, by acute and chronic. So all the basis of that we have to individualize the case. लेकिन ये कब होगा? Whenever you are examining the case or you are examining the disease properly. This individualizing examination of a case of a disease for which I shall only give in this place general directions. जैसे मैंने पहले कहा था कि he is giving जो general direction. You can add, you can replace anything according to your own practice, according to your own observation. Of which the practitioner will bear in mind only what is applicable to each individual case. जैसे मैंने अभी कोमल को कहा कि we have to follow one thing, that is the similia similibus curantum. So you can give the cure by giving the nosode, by giving the sarcode, or by giving the acute prude medicine. So now he is giving the general rule. You have to follow this rule with the help of similarity. लेकिन ये रूल में आप कुछ कुछ रूल छोड़ भी सकते हो, कुछ उसमें आप ऐड भी कर सकते हो, बट फिर से दूसरा क्या है, यू हैव टू इंडिविजुअलाइज दैट केस. द प्रैक्टिशनर विल बेयर इन द माइंड ओनली व्हिच इज एप्लीकेबल इन ईच इंडिविजुअल केस. जैसा एक्यूट है तो ये थिंग्स नहीं लगेंगी, क्रॉनिक है तो ये थिंग्स नहीं लगेंगी, उसमें से आप कुछ ना कुछ माइनस या प्लस कर सकते हो. डिमांड्स ऑफ द फिजिशियन नथिंग बट द फ्रीडम फ्रॉम प्रेजुडाइज एंड साउंड सेंसेस. सो वॉट सेकेंड थिंग ही हैज गिवन कि आप चीजें यूज कर सकते हो, इसमें से आप कुछ कम कर सकते हो, बट सेकेंड बेसिक थिंग इन्होंने बताया, यू शुड बी अनप्रेजुडाइज विथ योर साउंड सेंसेस. If you are not free from your prejudicedness, then ये general rules आपको कुछ काम में नहीं आएंगे. You have to be free from all the क्या बोलते हैं उसको biasness. Attention in observing and fidelity in tracing the picture of the disease. Fidelity means truth. You have to be attentive. You have to be good observer so that you will observe all the changes that are occurring in the patient and then you will get the true picture of the disease. So this is the basic thing which is required before the case taking. Every practitioner should bear in the mind these common rules. He can change the common rule according to the patient, according to the individual case. But what the common thing is required for every case, that you should be unprejudiced, you should be a proper observer, you should get or you should try to get all the genuine symptoms from the patient so that the true picture of that portrait or the portrait of the disease will be a true one. So this basic thing which is given in the aphorism number 83. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
केस टेकिंग शुरू करने से पहले आपको क्या चीजें आनी चाहिए?
प्रॉपर ऑब्जर्वर, ट्राई टू गेट जेन्युइन सिम्टम्स.
यस, वेरी गुड. सो दीज थ्री थिंग्स आर बेसिक थिंग्स एंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट यू कैन फॉलो दीज कॉमन डायरेक्शंस और द जनरल डायरेक्शंस एंड according to individual case, you can change that general directions. लेकिन उसको हमको manipulate नहीं करना है, ध्यान में रखना. जो general directions दिए हैं, they should not be manipulated. यानी अपने मन से ही उसको कुछ भी उसका गलत मतलब नहीं निकालना है. These general rules आप कम करना है तो आप कर सकते हो according to, but it should not be manipulated. Now we will see from the aphorism 84 what general rules are. Described by Dr. Hanneman. Read 84 aphorism. Anyone?
Ma'am, me vachu.
Tus ka, dusre ka nahi vachat koni. Tejasvini vach? Sushant vach? Konen tari ek vacha?
मैम तेजस्विनी
हां
हां द पेशेंट डिटेल्स अदर हिस्ट्री ऑफ हिज सफरिंग्स दोस अबाउट हिम टेल व्हाट दे हर्ड हिम कंप्लेन ऑफ हाउ ही हैज बिहेव्ड एंड व्हाट दे हैव नोटिस्ड इन हिम द फिजिशियन सीज हियर्स एंड remarks by his other senses what there is of an altered or unusual character about him. It's now greatly what all that the patient and his friends have told him in the very expressions used by them. Keeping silence him allows them to say all they have to say and refrains from the interrupting them.
Rejoin meeting after 5 to 7 minutes, sir. Continue.
And unless they wander off to the to other matters, the physician advises them at the beginning of the examination to speak slowly in order to in order that he may take down in writing the important parts of what the speaker say.
Right. Read that footnote also.
Every interruption breaks the train of thought of the narrators and all they would have said at first does not again occur to them in precisely the same manner after that.
Okay, so in this aphorism he has given the first rule.